Hi everyone, myself Anjana. I'm going to take lecture about centrifugation. Centrifugation is the separation and sedimentation of subcellular fractions of the homogenate according to their size, mass, density and relative gravity. As we all know, a cell which containing many cell organelles and macromolecules, for the study of structure and function of these subcellular fractions, we use a separation technique, that is centrifugation. Instrument used for centrifugation is centrifuge, and a centrifuge which consists of a pivoted cylinder called a rotor in which samples are placed, and this rotor which spins or rotates around a central axis at very high speed which produce a gravitational force which is greater than the earth's gravity, and the high rotational speed of the rotor which produces a centrifugal force which is directed away from the center. Then according to the principle of centrifugation, it is related to the gravitational force and the centrifugal force, the formation of centrifugal force for the sedimentation of different fractions. The centrifugal force, which is directly proportional to the radius of rotation and the speed of rotor, and the relative centrifugal force, that is RCF, which is a force acting on the sample during centrifugation, it is directly proportional to the number of revolutions per minute, that is RPM, and the radius of rotations and gravitational force. It is represented by a formula, that is RCF is equal to W square R by 980, where RCF is the relative centrifugal force and W, which is the revolutions per minute, that is the angular velocity of rotations, that is RPM, and R, which is the radius of rotation. Then the centrifugal force or the centrifugation which caused the samples to move away from the center and sediment or settle on the outer wall of the surface according to their sedimentation ratio. So heavier particles which move away first and get settled on the outer wall of the tube, and the lighter particles which follow their regular or relative sequence in according to their decreasing mass. Then the relation between intensity of centrifugal force and the sedimenting particle, which is represented by another formula, that is F is equal to mw square r, where F is the intensity of centrifugal force and m is effective mass of sedimenting particles, and w, which is the angular velocity of rotation, that is rpm, and the r, which is the distance between the sedimenting particle and the center of axis of rotation. So during centrifugation, the sample particles which get settled down on the bottom of the vessel due to gravity, and these rotating or spinning of samples which create a centrifugal force on the sample particles, and it increases the rate of sedimentation. So the rate of sedimentation of particle during centrifugation is known as sedimentation ratio, and it is having a unit of measurement called Swedberg unit, which is represented by capital S, and the suspension left after the centrifugations above the sediment, which is known as supernatant, which is acclimatized for repeated centrifugations in successive higher speed, and the suspension left after the final centrifugation, which is known as soluble fraction, which consists of enzymes and low molecular weight substances like amino acids, sugars, etc. So for classical centrifugations, the centrifugation of a substance or the separation of substance occur in an order of order in which nuclear fraction, then mitochondrial, then microsomal, and finally the soluble fraction. And for the separation of RNA and DNA, we apply some advanced type, that is density gradient centrifugations for the separation of RNA and DNA. Then based on the type of centrifuges and their centrifugation, mainly three types of centrifuges can be seen, that is low speed centrifuges, high speed centrifuges and ultra centrifuges. Low speed centrifuges, which are mainly used for the separation of higher molecular weight substance having an maximum speeds of 5000 RPM and RCF value of 3000 gram, and it is mainly used at room temperature and having no temperature control system. But high speed centrifuges, that is advanced type when compared to low speed centrifuges, having a temperature control system and having an average speed of 20,000 RPM. So it is mainly used for temperature sensitive biological, for the centrifugation of temperature sensitive biological substance, that is enzymes, for example enzymes. And it is also used for the separation of subcellular fractions like mitochondria, nucleosome, etc. It is also used. And the finally, ultracentrifuges. Ultracentrifuge is the most advanced type of centrifuges, which having an speed of 75,000 RPM and a 5 lakh gram centrifugal force. It having a refrigerator system having a temperature in between 0 to 4 degrees Celsius. And it is mainly used for the separation of proteins, enzymes and nucleic acids. And ultracentrifuges, which is again divided into two types, that is preparatory and analytical. Preparatory centrifuges, which is mainly used for biochemical investigations, and it is mainly used in density gradient differential centrifugation. And analytical centrifugation, which is a more advanced type from primitive centrifuges, ultracentrifuges, which having a visual system with windows that we can visually see the sedimentation of particles through our eyes. So it having an visual operating system with windows, and it is mainly used for the study of purity of macromolecules and the relative molecular mass of solute, and it is also used for the conformational change of protein structure. So these are the details about centrifugations and the types of centrifuges and their application and their principles. Thank you.